Welcome to an introduction to HWiNFO. We already touched on various helpful tools for benchmarking and monitoring. See the info cards for that. This time we want to go a bit deeper into HWiNFO. You can download it for free on the official homepage, which is also linked in the video description. After starting it, you will be greeted with the option to run sensors only or summary only, or simply run both by not ticking any box. For the purpose of this video, I chose to see all information. At first, it might be a bit overwhelming, but we will go through the most important aspects of every window. Please note that there is so much more to discover on HWiNFO, and to keep the video relevant, we will focus on the most common and helpful aspects. The very first one that greets you when you simply click Run will be the system summary for CPU, GPU, as well as mainboard, drives, and memory. On the left hand side you will see the CPU and on the right hand side the GPU information. In case you have more than one of those, you can select the other via the drop down menu. My i7-4790K is shown with its TDP, base and boost clock and also the voltage. Right below is the motherboard and its BIOS date and version. The attached drives are also shown. The ASUS ROG Strix GTX 1080 is shown with the current clocks and that's about it. Right below is the memory section, but you can select each bank and see size, clock and so forth. A bit more comprehensive is the following window. Each component and all of the information it can find about it, as you can see here, for instance the CPU. You can also save a report in all kinds of different formats, for example to send a friend for getting help in troubleshooting. However, for monitoring purposes you want to click on sensors. Sensors include every sensor you can think of in your PC. You can pick whatever sensor you like. You will see the current, the minimum, the maximum and the average read of that sensor. For instance, take the CPU temperature, indicated by a little thermometer. Depending on your CPU, you will have different number of cores. Please note that AMD CPUs do not show separate core temperatures. It is very helpful to run this while gaming or to see the temperature before, during and after overclocking and stressing your CPU. If you want to have a chart, simply click right on the sensor of your choice and select Show Graph. You can also adjust the looks of the graph to your liking. If you want to reset the minimum, maximum and average numbers shown, you can simply click on the clock at the bottom. You can also log all of the data by clicking on the little sheet with the plus sign. It will create a CSV file to open in Excel, R and the likes. In case you want to change the order of these sensors being displayed, you can obviously drag and drop them to your liking. You can of course restore the original order in the layout tab in the program settings. Additionally, you can choose to expand the window, meaning you can put more information next to each other to maybe put on a separate monitor. You can also adjust the different sensors being shown in the layout tab of the settings. Simply select a sensor and disable monitoring. If you have one, two or maybe three very important sensors that you want to monitor at all times, you can put it into the system tray using the system tray tab in the program settings. You can obviously adjust the color and transparency for better reading. You can also, via the OSD tab, enable and set up an on-screen display. However, we found it much more convenient to use the MSI Afterburner for that task. See the linked video in the info cards for that. So this is how you use HWiNFO in a nutshell. Like this video if you liked it, comment more suggestions down below and subscribe to help the channel. We will see you in the next one.